We've seen how it's possible to use Salenki circuits to design either a two-pole low-pass filter or a two-pole high-pass filter. If we wanted instead to make a two-pole bandpass filter, the appropriate circuit to use is the Delyiannis-Friend circuit. A Delyiannis-Friend circuit allows creation of a two-pole filter using just one op-amp. The appropriate time to use such a filter is when the pass band, or the distance in terms of frequency between a high pass and low pass side of a filter, is not very large. Let's go ahead and design one of these Delyiannis-Friend filters. It turns out that it's very easy to do. In the Delyiannis-Friend bandpass filter, we need to specify the cutoff frequency F sub B, the width of the pass band, and the DC magnitude. Let's draw all of these down. What does a transfer function look like for a Delyiannis-Friend bandpass filter? We have a particular frequency, which I'll label F sub B, which labels the center of the passband. We have a passband gain of H naught, and then we have a certain width in terms of the frequency B. The Delyiannis-Friend circuit is a two-pole filter. It also has one zero, which means that one of the poles is acting on the high-pass side and one of the poles is acting on the low-pass side. So we end up with 20 dB per decade falloff on either side. And if I'm plotting on a logarithmic scale, then this should actually be 20 log times the DC gain. The passband is designed as being 3 decibels down from the center of the filter. What if we wanted to plot this on a linear scale rather than a logarithmic scale? How would this change? On a linear scale, 3 decibels corresponds to half of the power at the center, which corresponds to 1 over square root of 2 times the voltage. So this is 0.707 times H naught would be zero. And our graph would look something like this. After we design the filter, we should be able to obtain the design, a capacitor and 3 resistors, as you can see in the circuit. It turns out that it's very easy to design one of these Delyiannis-Friend filters. Once we specify the key parameters, then we can just use these 3 formulas in order to calculate the appropriate values of the resistors. We can choose whatever convenient capacitor value C that we want. Now let's move on to the example problem. Let's design a bandpass filter that has the center of its pass band at 1 kilohertz. The pass band is 200 hertz wide, and the DC gain is 10. In these circuits, Q stands for quality factor, and we've seen this before with the passive filters. The quality factor is F sub B divided by B, that is the frequency divided by the passband. So the sharper the filter's response, the higher the value of Q. In this particular example, 1 kilohertz divided by 200 hertz is 5. We can use that in these formulas. As the center frequency for this filter lies in the medium audio range, we can choose a mid-value capacitance. I've chosen 8.2 nanofarads. It turns out that this yields resistors that are in the kiloohm range. We now have enough information to find the 3 resistors. Since we know Q, we know C, and we know F sub B, we can now calculate a value for R sub 3. It turns out that this will be 194 kiloohms. We can choose a standard 196 kiloohm resistor with 1% tolerance, for example. Knowing R3, we can then plug it into the equation for R2, since we already know the quality factor Q and the DC gain. R2 turns out to be 2.427 kiloohms. We could choose a 2.43 kiloohm resistor, for example. And then finally, we can calculate R1, which turns out to be 9.707 kiloohms. We could choose, for example, a resistor that has 9.76 kiloohms. This completes the design of this particular Delyiannis-Friend bandpass filter.